Welcome to the Boars Head Bistro, coffee shop and boutique hotel. The Boars Head has been here since 1724, overlooking one of the most interesting history-filled rivers of the world. And it has some of the most beautiful views in the city of Sunderland. As we start our mile and a half walk from the Boars Head, taking in the amazing views looking upriver to Wearmouth Bridge and beyond, be sure to keep watching as we tear wide open past secrets of Sunderland East End history, many of which are almost forgotten in time. Walking downhill past the bus stop, take the first left into Hartley Street. Walk 200 yards uphill, and on the left is Keelboat Lodge, built on the site of the Garths. Five tenement blocks stretching from here back to the Boars Head Bistro, which is the white building seen on the left of the picture. Walk on for another 20 yards, and follow Church Walk on your right. Trafalgar Square is on the left, built 4 years before Trafalgar Square in London, to house retired seafarers who fought in the Battle of Trafalgar. Next is Donison School Visitor Centre, a Georgian school room built in the heart of Sunderland East End in 1798, with a programme of heritage, educational and community events for all ages. Shortly, we will reveal the first of many past secrets, followed by a special free promotion from the Boar's Head with amazing prizes. But first, we visit Holy Trinity Parish Church, a Grade 1 listed building, dated 1719, and one of the oldest buildings in Sunderland East End. This church was also home to the first Sunderland Town Council, the first library where you see the original bookshelves and the first fire pump was stored here. The enclosed land to the right of the picture is the Great Memorial Gardens, with its monument to Jack Crawford, a Sunderland-born press-ganged sailor, known as the Hero of Camperdown. Souls lie just beneath your feet in this small grassed area. The enclosure is a memorial to Reverend Robert Gray, Rector of Sunderland from 1819 till 1838, which includes the cholera outbreak of 1831. We now return to the church, cross the lane to Trinity Square and take the first right. The first house opposite Trinity Square is the former Sunderland Hospital, dated 1867 on the inscription above. Retrace your steps again, turn right and 100 yards up on the right is Lombard Street. Turn right here and walk to the building in front of you, which is the Phoenix Hall. This is another Grade 1 listed building, dated 1783, and the oldest Masonic temple still in existence and in regular use today. Besides being used by members, it is available to hire as a function suite by the public. From the Masonic Temple, take the cut to James William Street. Turn left to return to High Street East, with the university students' flats facing you. Then right to Church Street East and walk uphill. 100 yards on the left is another Grade 1 listed building, number 10 Church Street, built by merchant John Freeman in 1711, and it is now a biker's bar. Now cross the lane to Sunderland Maritime Heritage Centre, where volunteers restore historic small boats and keep alive the great shipbuilding record of Sunderland East End. Returning to High Street East, cross the road and follow the footpath down to Sunderland East End Fish Quay. Here you can watch the fishermen unloading their catches and buy fresh fish. We're just about to reveal a hidden gem about the Boar's Head. So head back towards the Boar's Head Bistro while enjoying the views upriver to Wearmouth Bridge and downriver to Sunderland Marina, with Sunderland University campus and the National Glass Centre on the opposite bank. Directly ahead are the gates to Sunderland South Dock, where the tall ships race Sunderland 2018 will be centred. Here's a glimpse of how it may look. This is Blythe Tall Ships Race, with just 30 ships visiting. Sunderland will have over 80 tall ships, over three times more than Blythe. The Boar's Head Bistro is at the heart of this Sunderland events promotion, and already taking bookings for the Tall Ships Race 2018, which is held on July 11th to the 14th, 2018. 80 tall ships are expected to be tied to moorings with incredible views from the Boar's Head outside terraces, so book your place here early. Now return to the Boar's Head Bistro up historic Yule's Passage, steeped in the history of Sunderland East End. Now we reveal our luxury ensuite bedrooms, all themed on past Sunderland East End and historic Sunderland events. Residents enjoy their own raised outdoor patio. Breakfast, lunch and evening meals can be bought from our bistro from 9 a.m. until 9 p.m. and enjoyed either in our conservatory with panoramic river views or our residence-only kitchen, available throughout your stay at the Boar's Head Bistro, coffee shop and boutique hotel. You can see the total walk was just 1.5 miles or 2.5 kilometres, but with so much to see, it could easily take a full hour. The Boar's Head Boutique Hotel welcomes early bookings from guests visiting the Tall Ships Race Sunderland 2018 from the 11th to the 14th of July 2018 and Sunderland Air Show 2 weeks later from July 27th to the 29th 2018. Be first to be informed of our latest videos by clicking the like and share icons below this video. And please comment what you would like to see next on video about Sunderland East End. Also, for your opportunity to win amazing prizes, follow us on facebook.com/Boar's Head Bistro.